We bless the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We're just going to play a little music. Good evening, each and every one that is will be watching, hearing. Hallelujah. Let me play a music for a while. I hold no copyright for this music. Hallelujah. But we are going to go into Genesis 35. Hallelujah. Good evening. Good night, everyone. Hallelujah. We bless the name of Jesus. We honor God and we give him glory. We give him honor and praise in the mighty name of Jesus. Right now, oh God, I cover this environment with the blood of Jesus and the fire of the Holy Ghost. Let us pray. Oh, let us pray and take authority over the environment right now, oh God. I ask you to saturate this page right now with the blood of Jesus and the fire of the Holy Ghost. Lord God, I from the day of John the Baptist, the kingdom of heaven suffered violent, and violent take it by force. Right now, in the name which is above all name, the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, the Son of the living God, I take authority, O God, over this environment right now, oh God, the hemisphere, the stratosphere for the east, west, north, and south. I take authority right now, oh God, internationally, locally, right now, in the mighty name of Jesus. The four corner of the earth right now is covered with the blood of Jesus. Lord, as I come tonight to read your word, to dissect the word of God, I plead the blood of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, the Son of the living God. When you plead the blood of Jesus, that's a powerful weapon of spiritual immunity. Lord, we want spiritual immunity tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I want you, oh God, to let access me and have me to use the blood of Jesus right now, oh God, to give your children and myself great deliverance in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, right now, oh God, I use the blood of Jesus as a sanitizing weapon, oh God. I use the blood of Jesus, oh God, when I'm facing tough battle tonight, in the mighty name of Jesus. I use the blood of Jesus tonight to establish our victory in the mighty name of Jesus. I use the blood of Jesus tonight, oh God, to combat evil forces that around my atmosphere, around the hemisphere. I come against every witchcraft, cauldron, witches, and warlock tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus, I use the blood of Jesus, oh God, against every spiritual serpent and wickedness. I plead the blood of Jesus against every germ, oh God, and demonic entity in the mighty name of Jesus. I use the blood of Jesus tonight, oh God, to barricade my life with the blood, to barricade the people, the true servant, the true remnant of God tonight, with the blood of Jesus. Rabando Shigorobosaya Magadaba Sendian Roboshia. Lord, tonight, oh God, we take spiritual immunity with the blood of Jesus. Lord, I use it as a weapon tonight, oh God. Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth is back up with the total power of God. The blood of Jesus of immune spiritual change. Right now, oh God, I use the blood of Jesus, oh God, for each and every one deliverance that is listening in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, Savior divine, I ask you to have your will and your way in the mighty name of Jesus. Father God, I ask you, oh God, as we use the blood of Jesus, we use it as a battle. We use this as a dimension and a complex of the blood of Jesus. And this prayer line tonight, in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord God, as we study your word, oh God, we are asking you, God, for spiritual understanding. We're asking you for spiritual knowledge, the knowledge of you, oh God, as we break bread with your word. The word, oh God, is sharper than any two-edged sword tonight, and it breaks asunder in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord, I just ask you tonight, oh God, that your children, not the children of Satan, not the children of Lucifer, Lord, your children will understand the word of God tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. I thank you, Abba Father. I bless your name. And I cover and I infuse myself with the blood of Jesus as I hide behind the cross tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We just bless the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. For some of you that might not hear and just joining in, I have been reading from Genesis chapter 1 for the last 6 weeks or 7 weeks. And we are dissecting the word of God. Hallelujah. In the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. The last week while I was on, I was doing Genesis 34. In which we were discussing with Dana and what had happened with Dana incident. So God, I pray that your children get spiritual understanding. I get spiritual understanding as I break through the word, as I go through your word in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I ask every principality to scatter in the mighty name of Jesus. While we're reading through Genesis, we were reading through Genesis chapter 1. going on to, as we reach now, Genesis chapter 4, and we are going, Genesis chapter 34, I'm sorry, and we are going on in now to Genesis chapter 35. I just want to recap a little on Genesis chapter 34, while we were reading that. I just want to recap about what we were saying. Well, as a matter of fact, not what we were saying. What the Spirit of the Lord was saying to the church. What the Spirit of the Lord was saying to the church. If you ask me what church, I say you, because we are the church. Hallelujah. We are the church. So while the Lord was dissecting the Word of God, and we were listening to the Word of God, and getting spiritual knowledge and understanding with the Word of God, we can see where from Genesis chapter 1, what happened in the garden at Eden. God bless you, woman of God. What happened in the garden of Eden? What also happened with Noah? Oh God, this word, the Old Testament, is such a beautiful, beautiful word of God that is encrypted. And we have to unlock to see what is going on. Because what is going on right now, it went on in true Genesis. Hallelujah. So as we go through Genesis tonight, in the mighty name of Jesus, hallelujah, we recap where I stop. In Genesis 34, we were talking about and discussing about apparently what had happened to Dinah. Dinah was Leah's only daughter. That was the only daughter, I think, of Jacob. It was natural for her to seek companionship, you know, with other women. I'm not talking about lesbian lifestyle. I'm not beating down on any lesbian or any gay, because I am not God. But what I'm trying to say, that Dinah need like a mentor. And Dinah was leading her mother, you know, and that is natural for us to do. But what happened, we see where Shechem notice Dinah and force her to have intercourse, sexual intercourse. That term violate her. It translates as violate, the same word used for Ammon, like a, you know, is a rape. He violate her. She loved Dinah. The expression spoke, but I am asking myself while I meditate on the word, if you love someone, why would you rape them? If you love them, why couldn't you not respect their body? Why couldn't you not honor their body to wait in marriage? You are going to rape someone, and then you are going to ask your father to ask for Dana Han in marriage, which don't make any sense to me. But we are going to go into the word and see what the Lord is saying. Because if you recap back on Genesis chapter 34 verse 5, you can see that when Jacob heard, he was enraged. He was angry. He was angry. And he was thinking about his daughter has been defiled, and to make her unclean. So I am assuming, and based off what the word of God said, he was obsessed. He was very upset, because this guy Shem, he was uncircumcised. And here is Jacob's son that took the symbol of the holy faith. They took the symbol of the holy faith and used it as a weapon against their foe. Back then, you have to be circumcised. And what they do, their circumcision was holy. Circumcision is still holy. So circumcision make you clean. When the Jews have their boys, baby, in the hospital, they do not circumcise them in the hospital. They have a thing that they call set. After 8 days, when the baby is like 8 days old, the rabbi would come into the house and the rabbi would circumcise the young baby. Hallelujah. So based off that, what Shechem did, he he provoke his love for Daniel. He tried to prove his love for Daniel, his willingness to undergo circumcision. But I am saying, you in love with Dana, why would you defile her with your unclean self and then want her hands in marriage? How can that be blessed? So when we go on now to and look at chapter 35, we will see what the Spirit of the Lord is saying. And let me break down, then I will drop down to verse 18 in Genesis 34 and go and see where he want Shem, he want to do the circumcision. But I cannot understand the reason for the rape. I cannot understand why you rape her and then you want the blessing of a father to marry the daughter. Personally, I would not do it, but you know, I am not God. I'm just his servant. I am just his vessel that is avail myself for him to use me. You know, I'm looking down at 27, and most likely Jacob, other son, joins Simeon and the Levi in plundering the city. And you know, I believe Jacob's son, let righteous anger over sin turn into unrighteous, unforgiving vengeance. You know, at your quiet time, you can look in Ephesians chapter 4, verse 26, and read it in the entirety to see what have taken place. Hallelujah. But what I could see, that Jacob had rebuked his son for their terrible behavior. You know, he did not want them to behave like that, but they behaved due to their sister. So he rebuked them in the name of the Lord. Instead of making the family a blessing to other nation, so he rebuked them in the name of the Lord. I am here tonight to tell you, saints, that it's okay to have righteous indignation. It's okay to be angry, because what people will do to you and how people will use you and abuse you, it's okay. As long as you don't take that anger to bed with you, it is okay. Don't let anyone tell you, because you are a Christian, I'm a child of God. I'm a daughter of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, the Son of the Living God. I'm not going to declare a Christian, me my personal self, because I have suffered with the so-called Christian hands. And this is why I'm doing the podcast like, oh, I'm doing it right now, until the Lord release me to go otherwise. But right now he said, do like this, and this is what I'm doing right about my father's business. Hallelujah. So I hope you have an understanding of Genesis chapter 34. So now we are going to go into Genesis chapter 35 in the mighty name of Jesus. You see, I was doing it on Messenger, and there were so many Achans on the line, so many witches and warlock that was on the line. You know, I have to protect the grace and the anointing that the Lord has placed up on my life. And whatever he said I should do, I will do it as unto the Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So I'm going to start reading. And Lord, I pray for the wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. I pray that your children would have the wisdom, knowledge, and the understanding of you, O God, in the mighty name of Jesus. So as I read Genesis 35, hallelujah, lando soko dobo shaya. Then God said to Jacob, arise, go up to Bethel and dwell there, and make an altar there to God, who appeared to you when you fled from the face of Esau, your brother. I think we have done this already, but someone messaged me and they said they did not get Genesis chapter 35. You know, and so I will inconvenience everyone just to please one. Hallelujah. Just as the Lord did with the 99. The 100, one was gone. And he led the 99 to attend for the one. So I'm reading this back one over again so that the individual can have an understanding and the concept of it. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And Jacob said to his household and to all who were with him, put away the foreign god that are among you. Purify yourself and change your garment. Then let us arise and go up to Bethel, and I will make an altar there. I will make an altar there to God, who answer me in the day of my distress. Le Kandoshaya. God will answer you, saints of God, in the day of your distress. The Lord will answer you in the mighty name of Jesus, and has been with me in the way which I have gone. So they gave Jacob all their foreign gods, which were in their hands, and the earrings which were in their ears, and Jacob hid them under the turbot tree, which was by Shechem, and the terror of God was upon the city that were all around them. My God, and they did not pursue the son of Jacob. Hallelujah. So Jacob came to Luz, and that is Bethel. If you don't know, Luz is in Bethel, which is the land of Canaan. He and all the people who were with him, and he built an altar there and called the place El Bethel, because there God appeared to him when he fled from the face of his brother. You remember when he fled from the face of his brother, and when he went into this place. Hallelujah. You know, there are times when you will have to flee from someone. Not that you are afraid of them. Not that you are afraid to confront the confronter. But there's going to come a time in your life when you're going to have to cut away from some people. When you have to flee from some people. Not that you are afraid of them. But because your word is so potent, and your word is like a two-edged sword, and my word answered by fire. So what I do, I will just excuse myself from you, because I do not want the Lord God of Elijah to strike you down on my watch. So I will move away. Hallelujah. I will move away. So this is what he did. He moved away. And he think about his brother Esau, what he has done. Hallelujah. So now we read right now here at verse 8. Now Deborah, Rebekah's nurse, died, and she was buried below Bethel under the terebinth tree. So the name of it was called Alion Baliet. La manda da bashete kuda basaya. Ne basando do boshaya da basete. Iko dosha dosha bahaya mando shia laba. Ikando salaba haya da bahando robo shaya. Ikando seliando shaya. Mandaliando soko do boshaya. Le kandaya da sando shadiatai. Mandaliando soto do boshaya da bahai. Lega da basendeliako do boshikaya. Mando shia layando do bokaya. Le da sando do boshaya. As I look at verse chapter 1 and verse at verse 1 in chapter 35. Lekaduse liando jabahaya. Lebasand riando zagadabai. Lakadose panto shiandarabaya. Legadabo sandaliando shikadabahaya. Rabahando dorobo shiandarabai. Makadose lekandoshi biando roboshai. Lebahada bando sikireboshaya. Iande kiriando raboshatebai. As I look at this right here in chapter 35, verse 1, for a fifth time visit Jacob. God, for the fifth time, visit Jacob. If you see 28, chapter, verse 10, if you see all the time that God has visited Jacob, he had visited Jacob. And after the Debor at Shem, God told Jacob to continue to Bethel, the place where God first appeared to him. Sometime in life, many time in life, destruction will come your way. But the Lord God had answered down by fire. The Lord God that answered you by fire will tell you to go back to the place. And you have to go back to something. Sometimes we do not want to go back to our past. But sometimes it's good to go back to our past. Especially when you are instructed by the Most High God. Hallelujah. So what he did, he went even what had happened to Dana. He still did not let that distract him. He wanted to go back to the place that he first meet with the Lord. So what again, Jacob, what? He retraced his grandfather Abraham's route. Hallelujah. He retraced his grandfather's route. This is the first time in the Bible that God commanded an altar to be made for him. Abraham had constructed an altar, but no divine command was recorded. But a divine command is recorded when Jacob had made the altar unto the Lord with the stone. Hallelujah. I don't know if you are getting what I'm saying, but I pray that you will get the understanding. Glory to God. Then God appeared to Jacob again. Halabahaya. When he came from Padan Aram and blessed him, and God said to him, your name is Jacob. Your name shall not be called Jacob anymore, but Israel shall be your name. Halalala mandori yahaya. Yekodobo shi andarabaya. Mandu soto liyo soto. Lebahando sabahaya turire. Lingadobo saya dashaya. Yindiriando sokodobo shaya. I feel the Lord tonight. I feel the Lord tonight. I don't know if anyone has seen a change in my name, but I feel the Lord present tonight as I see where he called Jacob Israel. He changed his name. Whoever need to change your name, you need to change your name, because some of us name means serpent. Some of us name mean destruction. Some of us name mean demonic stuff. So we need to check the lineage of our name. Hallelujah. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hey, Karabando Raboshaya. Lebasando Raboshaya. So he called his name Israel. Also God said to him, I am God Almighty. Be fruitful and multiply. A nation and a company of nation shall proceed from you, and king shall come from your body. The land which I have gave Abram and Isaac, I give to you, and to your descendant after you, I give this place where he talked with God. Leba Shayadaba. I give you this land. Then God went up from him in the place where he talked with him. So Jacob set up a pillar in the place where he talked with the Lord, a pillar of stones, and he poured a drink offering. He poured a drink offering on it, and he poured oil on it. And Jacob called the name of the place where God spoke with him, he called it Bethel. I don't know if you see what is going on here, but just as the Lord has changed his name to Israel, he changed the name to Bethel. He did not call it Bethel at first, but now he changed it to Bethel. I don't know if you see the pattern in the bloodline that I will be doing shortly, but there's a pattern right here. I don't know if I'm going to finish the whole of this, but I'm going to try to do it in the name, mighty name of Jesus. And I read verse 16, and then I will dissect it. Then they journeyed from Bethel, and where there was but a little distance to go to Ephrath, Rachel labored in childbirth, and she had hard labor. Now it came to pass, when she was in hard labor, that the midwife said to her, "Do not fear, you will have this son also." And so it was, and as her soul was departing, for she died, Rachel had died in childbirth. Then she called his name Benoni, but his father called him Benjamin. So Rachel died and was buried on the way to Ephrath. This is Bethlehem. And Jacob set a pillar on her grave, which is the pillar of Rachel's grave to this day. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Then Israel journeyed. This is Jacob now, but his name is now Israel. Then he journeyed and pitched his tent beyond the Tower of Edom. And it happened when Israel dwelt in the land that Reuben went and lay with Bilhah, his father's concubine. And Israel heard about it. Now the son of Jacob were 12. The son of Leah were Reuben, Jacob firstborn, and Simon, Levi, Judah, Issachar, and Zebulun. The son of Rachel were Joseph and Benjamin. The son of Bilhah, Rachel's maidservants were Dan and Naphtali. And the son of Zilpah, Leah's maidservant, were Gad and Asher. These were the son of Jacob who were born to him in Padan Aram. Hallelujah. Then Jacob came to his father Isaac and at Mamre, at Kadesh Arba. This is Hebron, where Abram and Isaac dwelt. Now the days of Isaac were 180 years. So Isaac breathed his last and died, and was gathered to his people, being old and full of days, and his son Esau and Jacob buried him. Hallelujah, glory to God. We're going to take it nice and slow. So we are going to stop at Genesis 35 tonight in the mighty name of Jesus, because I need to show you something what is going on here. If you notice from Genesis chapter 1, from the Garden of Eden, sin has begun. But we are there were more than one wife, one husband with several different wives, and there were like infidelity and incest that started to go on and continue to go on. It continued to go on down in the bloodline. So when someone going to tell you that they do self-deliverance on themselves, then you need to run. Then you need to run from that individual. Self-deliverance is good when you can repent and said, yes, Lord, I did this. But get to an ears that can be confiding, or you write your transgression down and you're late at the altar. Get total deliverance. There is when you know that deliverer need deliverance. You get total deliverance. You see what is happening right now going through the bloodline. There were no deliverance that happened. So you find that there were a lot of stuff that was going on from Adam and Eve with the concubine when their womb had closed. They would go to their concubine because they cannot wait on the Lord. Right now we are not waiting on God. We want to go in front of the Lord. What I am gaining right here tonight, that what Jacob did when his name changed to Israel, he said, I will make an altar. Jacob declared his intention to obey God's command. How many of us are obeying God's command? How many of us the Lord is speaking to your heart right now for you to do something, for you to do something for somebody, and you willingly not doing it? You know, even though the pandemic is going on, even though the plague right now is going on, the Lord gave me a command the other day, and I went outside and I feed the people. I don't like to say homelessness and stuff like that. I said temporary inconvenience, and the food that I would take, consume in my body, that's what I give to them. I did not record their face, but I record their voices. And they said, I thank you. May God bless you. One lady have 7 children, and she was so happy to get the food because the Lord said to me, I need you to go to this location, and I need you to give out the food because you have more than enough home. And what I did, I obeyed the Lord, and I went there, and the Lord that answered it by fire, answer my prayer. How many of us willing and obedient to do what does say the Lord so we can eat the fruit thereof? How many of us are willing to do that? In spite of Dana's situation, in spite of his own girl child was defiled, in spite of that with Jacob, which now called Israel, what he did, he hold his cool and he went back to where the Lord has sent him, because he said, holy God, the living and holy God, they cleaned themselves. And he went there. He went back where the Lord would have him to go, because he have a covenant that God has made with his father, that God has made with his grandfather, and what God has made with him. So he went back there. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And he said he want to obey God's command. How many of us obeying God's command? He also said, who answer me has been with me. Lebando Shabahaya. Mando kudibo salama shikarai. Ye kadobo sandalabahia. He said, who answer me has been with me. He's saying, who had answer me has been with me. Jacob recalled God's constant protection. Did recall God's constant protection. You know, I know how God protect me. And I know what the Lord has saved me from, the device of the witches and the warlock. Because you cannot kill who God commands to live. You see, that could not kill Jacob. Because Jacob has a mission. Jacob was on a mission for the Lord. When you're on a mission for the Lord, yes, the warfare will come. The battle will come. But if you hold on to the unchangeable changer hand, he will never leave you or will he forsake you. In the mighty name of Jesus, Jacob, remember that God's constant protection was with him and his fulfillment of his promise, the reason to obey and worship God. How many of us is obeying God? How many of us is worshiping God? I strongly believe that we are not, some of us not going to listen until the heaven become brass and the earth become iron and you are dying for thirst. You are suffocating before you call on the Holy God, before you call on the Lord God of Israel, before you call on the Lord God of Elijah. Right now we have to wear in a face mask. Like 4 years ago I said, did a video, take off the mask, and someone did not like it, so they reported. Now we are wearing a face covering. Now we have to force to wear a mask. I am telling you right now, I don't think there is a Muslim, I'm sorry to say it, saint, if whether you hear or forbear, that of the COVID-19, I don't hear of it. If it happen, I don't hear of it. A lot of time, our disobedience, we have to pay because of our disobedience. How many of us would remember God's promise and do his fulfillment to worship him? As verse 4 suggested, that they're nearby with their foreign God. Jacob told them to take them off, and he hid them, he hid them, not where he was going. He is a trickster, but God still see him through. He did not go and hide it on the land where he was going. He went and he hid it. He hid it on the land where his daughter was defiled. Catch the flow with that. How strategic that is. That's what he went and he did. He hid it there where his daughter was defiled, because he did not want no unclean things with him. So I suggest right now what I am seeing, that what Jacob did, he did not want any idolatry. The two other passage that talk mention about the earring is in connection with the idolatry. At your quiet time, you look at Judges chapter 8, verse 22 to 28. Hosea chapter 2, verse 13. At your quiet time, and in many other passages, it talk about the earring. I am not going to tell you not to wear earring, because I do wear earring. Lebando sokodabo shaya, madiando soliando rabo shaya, makadabo seyando rabahaya, yedebo samandiando rabahaya, lebando dodabo sandiando rabo seya, yegodobo shaya rabahandai, lebahaya bo shikedebo, mandiando rabo shatia. This is a loving God and a living God and a loving God. And Jacob served the Lord. Israel served the Lord, and what he did, the tree that has a red berries and the leaf shaped like feather, because the tree live a long time. Ancient people often used the tree Terebinth, the tree of as a commemorate important event, or to mark the place of worship. So right now I leave you with this. I am going to continue on my other podcast, but right now I leave you with this for you to meditate on the word, study the word of God. take him at his word. Believe his prophet and you shall prosper in the mighty name of Jesus. This book is a love book. This book is a love letter. This book is a word map. The Holy Bible is your life giving. It's a life giver. You can use this word to navigate through your obstacle, your crisis, in the mighty name of Jesus. So I pray in the mighty name of Jesus tonight that as you meditate on Genesis chapter 35 and see what had happened, that the Lord will surely come to your help in the mighty name of Jesus. I am closing off on this podcast, and I will continue on the other one. So what you need to do, you can pick up on the other one. So may the Lord God of peace be with you tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of your life, and you will dwell in the house of the Lord. Amen.